Hey people, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today, again, we're playing with makeup because of course that's what we do on my channel. And I've got some new bits in. I think some of them are new, some of them are new to me. But I'll show you because I have some She Glam bought. A little haul. I didn't film it because some other stuff came behind and I had to check if everything was in one piece. So I'll just show you how it is. It's all out of packaging. But yeah, I got a little She Glam makeup this time. And again, with that order, I bought a little blouse. I hope you like it. So yeah, I got this cute little blouse with the trousers and a jacket. So maybe you'll see that around one day and get it filmed. And that's the one I had. I had to wait a long time because two items didn't come. I got a code refund and it still didn't came. So yeah, didn't have that much and it was time to check it before I could send anything back. But everything was perfectly fine, so I didn't have to send anything back, which is nice. And I really think I look cute in my little blouse. So yeah, I wore this over Christmas. If you like that, please subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell, give me a comment, give me a like. It would be amazing, mean the world to me. And let's just get into what I've got. I'll swatch everything now and then I'll use it. So that's why I already did my base and my concealer. My foundation and concealer. And we will use what I've got from now on from She Glam. And then after that, and then some stuff in between. I hope you just want to follow and join me. So first thing I've got is one of the liquid blushes. This is the color 101 in Love Cake. And look how cute this packaging looks. This is even... I love the detail. And it wasn't that expensive. So yeah, I really like it. I'm closing it down. There's a little ball in it. So I'm always assuming you have to shake it before use. So yeah. I won't swatch this because I think it's a shame to waste products from this. But this is what it looks like. I'll be putting it on my cheek. It's nice. It's pink. I really love this. I've tried this once on a live and it's fucking good. Or a video, I don't know. On a video, I think. Then I've also got a bronzer version. This is Golden Sun. Again, to shake it. Little ball is in it. The way what I don't get of these are look amazing. And look at that color, also very pretty. But I don't know if you can see that, but there's just a top with two holes in it, which makes this the color on. So I'm hoping that the shaking means that it gets on here. And that even though there's just a little left, you could get everything out because of the stopper. You can't reach to the bottom. So I hope that's what that means. But yeah, we'll see when we get there. Probably gonna take a while because I have enough makeup. I have a lot of makeup. So yeah, probably that will happen. If I look above the camera, I'm sorry, but that's what my mirror is at. So as I can see, I'm in the frame. Because my last video I just finished editing is on, will be soon. It will be on here already when this comes out. But my lips weren't in focus and my eyes were a lot of out of sight. So I've tried making sure I'm in frame. So if I'm looking there, then that's why. Then I've got an eyeshadow palette. This is the This is the Chromazone eyeshadow palette. And then Velocity, because I think there are two of them, maybe I'm wrong. And this is this gorgeous thing. I love the shimmeries. It's just a neutral matte, but that you can do a fine eye look with it. Then some shimmers. I don't have that much arm space, so I'll see where I put it. So yeah, so there are no names on it, so I'm just going to go in with this. Ooh, hard to get into with your finger. Then this one, then this one, and then this one. And I'll just swatch them on my hand. That would be easier. Yeah, that's the first four. Let's see. Oh, this looks an old and orangey one. That is pretty. And I also like, that's the purpley shimmery. That's a black base. That's also real pretty. I did put a picture on Instagram of the products. So, and Gina suggested I should do a sensitive look with my palette. So we'll see. Because I've got one more eyeshadow palette. So we're going to mix palettes today. So yeah, I'm sorry if you don't like this. The bottom row, this is, I think, a black, a dark brown, gorgeous, I don't know what to call this color, but it's duochrome-y. From this side it looks like a pinky green, but I look at the front, it looks like a bluey purple. I don't know if you guys can see the shift in this palette, but I really like it. I don't know, can you see the shift on my fingers? I don't know. So yeah, let's just do these here, for fuck's sake, why not? Ooh, those, oh, that's, yeah, that is such a pretty shade. It still looks bluey purple, but I bet you there's also some pink in there, and this one is also a duochrome. That's also pretty. Yeah, I really like this palette. It looks really nice. My swatches are awful, but that's also because my setup is not perfect at the moment. And if anyone knows how to connect your iPhone to a Samsung tablet to use it as a monitor, then please let me know. That would be really amazing, but I have no clue how to pull it off, so I'm not too technical. So yeah, that was this cute little palette. The swatches are already gone, because yeah, I am scared of putting it all in my new clothes. Didn't think of that when I started this. Then I've got a lippy with a liner and a lip shade, which was interesting to me. So yeah, this is I'll do it like this, I'm sorry, so I can see what I'm doing. Yeah, that's a really dark side on one side. So just put it up, it's like in here, it's not going very smoothly, but... And then we've got the other side, which is the lipsticky side. Which is also quite nice. It's a brownie. Ooh, that would be interesting. I think I like this with a Sun City look. That is a pretty shade. That would be nice, not as neutral. I like that. Then I've got a eyebrow pencil. I think I've got a wrong one when I saw Missa, because I've got one with a spoolie, which is, yeah, nice, normal, fine spoolie, nothing wrong. And then the very small pencil. Ooh, that's sharp. Line, it's a really sharp line. This is She Glam. This is the skinny brow pencil in, I think I've got brown, but yeah, it doesn't say a color in it, but I think I've got brown, so it's a skinny brow pencil. We'll see how good it is. Oh, let's see if I can have the lipstick. Is a Glam 101 from She Glam in the color Deep Caramel. I don't think I checked that when I bought it. I just thought, interesting, let's just pop it in. Maybe I didn't, this is a while ago that I ordered it. And then I've got a highlight. It's the Cosmic Crystal Mousse Highlighter in Vanilla Sky. Oh yeah, let's just swatch that as well. Oh, that feels really nice. That's also very nice. Out of frame a little. Oh, look at that shimmer, that's nice. I think that's the right color for me. I don't have to need it too light. And then, last but not least, I've got the She Glam Fun Within Wild Heat Palette. Wild Heat She Glam Fin Within Palette. It says on this side, so yeah. Oh, this is cute with glitters in it, and this has names on it, so that's maybe a nice. Well, this interesting glitter looks like a sort of a mermaid halo glow glitter. That's interesting. So let's just swatch. Oh, that's nice. They feel not hard, they feel really nice as well. And this one. Oh, this one feels nice. Oh god. Can I hold this while I'm doing this? I don't know. So this is Aqua Glam. Ooh. This is Glass Flipper. Look at that. This is Guilty Pleasure. And this is Deep Blue. Oh, okay. That's interesting. Deep Blue was really, really soft and felt really nice. This is all on my fingers, but a hand now, but look, my fingers are almost clean. So I've put everything on my arm, which is quite interesting to me. Because yeah, I don't know, can you see? There's almost nothing left on my hand. It's all on my arm. Quite impressive, I think. Even the glitter. There's not much on my swatching fingers, just on my... That's nice. I like that. I'm gonna put this all on my new trousers. Maybe that's not a good idea, to film in new clothes. Oh well. Then we've got second row. Oh yeah. It feels like glitter, but like really nice. This is also nice. Ooh, in yellow. So yeah, this is the second row. Gonna hold my palette again, even though I already swatched the first one. This was Just Add Water. That's a show. Water Orchid. Bubble Trouble. That's an oh, that's pretty too. And Island Fever. Ooh, that's a bright yellow. That is nice. Daniela, is that a good yellow? What do you think? I'm gonna definitely use that. So I think the Sunset Eye is a really good idea to try it all. I've already took it off my fingers, but again, it wasn't much there. This time the yellow was a little bit more on there, but not bad, not bad at all. And then we're going in with the last row. And that is gonna be these. Oh, that feels even better than all the other shades. Yeah, I really like the feel of this palette. That feels really nice and luxurious. And I'm closing the palette up again. And I want to hold it next to me so I can swatch it. Oh, there's a hair in my finger. I don't know if you can see it, but oh well. Hooked on You. Oh, look at that. God. Swim for the Win. Coat Tails, I think. C-O-T-E and then Tails. And then Grand Finale. That's funny to be the last one. I did like that yellow too. Look at that glitter. People, wow. Okay, there's a little bit more left on my fingers from this one. Wow, okay. I really like this. There's some swatching of someone else here. Look at that. Look at this glitter. I mean... And they felt so nice, the glitters. No sharp edges, nothing like that. Oh, I really like this palette. I love this. Ooh, I'm so excited to play with all of this now. I'm really happy with this. So let's just get in with the makeup. So we're going to start with my Chic Lamb bronzer in Golden Sun. Shake it again, just in case that's necessary. I don't know. And then just put it here. And a little bit here. Oh, I think that's nice. It says bronzer, but that looks more like a contour shade to me. Because it's nice and cool toned, not as warm. Don't mind that at all. Then a little bit down there. I don't know why I'm doing that, but... Doesn't smell too good, but not too bad either. Let's go in my MF1 from Mitchell Brush, because yeah, that's what I like for doing this kind of stuff. I think that looks really nice. What do you guys think? That melts like butter into my skin though. I think I may need a little bit extra on my cheeks, but we'll see. And if this is any good, I want to save up to do a little shine Chic Glam haul again and do some foundation when this is any good. Oh, this looks amazing. But the looks of it with swatching, I really gonna like it, I think. And I already bought this way before Missa reviewed it, but it's so funny because, yeah, I just didn't have the time and the shizzle to do anything. But I thought it was so funny that she got... Some of the stuff I got as well, so. And after she did it, I wanted it all, so I already put it in my basket, even though I didn't try any of it yet. I'm gonna go in with my sponge to do the edges a little bit better. So I feel like I have too sharp of a line on my forehead. My cheek, just too sharp of a line here. I always feel like when I do it with a brush, it doesn't blend in that much, but I'm gonna put a little bit more on my cheeks. But when I do it with my brush, I have really sharp lines. But then when I go over with my sponge, I feel like sometimes I'm losing everything, but I don't know. That sounds weird, I don't know. Even though I do like this brush to put it to the test, but I'm wobbling, by the way, so if I don't make any sense, I'm sorry. That looks really nice though. Yeah, not blending that out again. That's the bronzer, I like that. That looks nice. Let's go in with the blush. Nice color, I think at least. Oh, that's a pretty pinky, soft pinky, I don't know. A little more on my apples of my cheek, because that's the way I like my blush. Maybe it's too much, I don't know. I did use this once, but I always feel like I'm using too much when I put this on, but I always have to remind myself that I always put on extra powder and everything, and then you just blend it away. I feel like it, and it's just not as much, so I always go in quite heavy with my liquids. And I still feel at the end it's not that heavy. Not that it has to be that heavy, but... And again, I'm going with my sponge. Because I think this is now too heavy, and I probably regret doing this, because now it's not heavy enough when I finish it in the end. Yep. And let's try this brow thingy, brushy thingy. I don't often use things like this. Oh, that's nice and sharp. Can you see them in between there? Oh, that goes on really nice, and it did get a lot darker. No, I think it works to make it a little bit more shaped. Because I always feel like I have a lot of hairs, but in some places I feel like my skin comes through a little bit too much. Oh well. Oh, that was nice. I went out of the lines, but like you see, I just pat it away on my skin. Just hope it doesn't get pat away on my brows, because I'm gonna throw again with this to blend it along. Which also works quite nicely, but now it's gone, but I feel like I like that better, a little bit more defined. Yeah, that's a nice pencil. And that for cheap and prices, I like that. I'll do my liquid highlight, powder, bronzer, blush, and then I'll come back for my highlight. So, let's go in with the highlighter. I already put some on my brush. And just let's go and kick this on here. Oh yeah. Of course, there's some liquid underneath for this one, which looked but a little like this. I didn't have an exact copy. I don't have that one. Not much liquid highlighters. I think I need some more of those. I have liquid highlighters. These two of these from Artitude. And I've got one from ColourPop, but that's in a pot. It's in a pot. Then I've got one from Benefit. I really don't like that much. Which I promised to send to Teresa, if I'm right, because I think it's her favorite. But yeah. Not done that yet, sorry. But this is nice. This is really nice. So yeah, I need more liquid highlighters, because I just got four, if I'm counting that right. Or my memory's bad and I'm forgetting one or two, but not much, as not as much. And of course, that's still enough for some people, but not for me. So that's my lips all done. Now let's get to go in with my eyes. You know the drill. It's going to be a voiceover, so enjoy it. We're going to start with my Refer 02 and this gorgeous black slate from the Chromazone palette. And look at it. Yeah, put it on already. Yeah, look. How beautiful and black. Just pat it on. Yes, I use an expensive brush. Yes, I don't know how this would work with a less expensive brush because I didn't try. But look at how black it is. And it's not expensive makeup. I did see in the end it looked like the color of Noir, which I agree. But it does not have the less stability Noir has. So it didn't stay black all day. It faded a little in the end. But still, see how it goes on. And it still lasted a long time, just not as long as ABH Noir. Honest, yeah. I just wanted to let you know and be honest about it. But look at this black go. I mean, yeah, I love it. I really like it. Even though it faded in the end a little more than other. But the black is so black. And let's be honest, I had it on for a long time, I think. Or did I do anything? I don't know. But it lasted through a night, so that's fine. And then we're going to get in with this gorgeous purple Swim for the Win with my GH40 brush. And it was only the black that faded a little. So not too much and not that noticeable. But yeah, I wanted to let you know and be honest about it. But look at these colors. How vibrant go they on the eye. And they stay so vibrant. I don't think I even had to give it more oomph. Had to go back in. I didn't. The colors just stayed on so nice. And look at this color. Yes, I'm using two palettes because, yeah, I could have used only the Chromazone and made a nice neutral look with a pop of color shimmer on the eye or not. But yeah, I just want to combine two palettes. I've not done that in a long, long time on my channel, if I ever have done that. But so yeah, but they are not expensive palettes, so you could get both. They're not expensive and they're really nice. I mean, look at these colors go. And for the price. I have got now my basket full with more She Glam stuff. Because I want the foundation, the concealer, I want the powder, I want a primer. I want more of those beautiful blushes. Now we're going to go in with this gorgeous pink. Look at this. Of course you can see, because I wrote everything down. This is Coattails, and this is on my E45 from Sigma. And look at this. It's just as vibrant as all the other shades. It's incredible. So yeah, I'm going to get more liquid blushes. Let's be honest, I do. Because those are in there already. I've got one more color. I've got now Love Cake and I want another. Maybe I keep collecting until I have them all. Because it's also pretty packaging and it works so nicely. Even though maybe I should wait until I got to the end and see if it still works when it's almost empty. But it takes too long. So probably not going to happen. But I could do that. I know I can't. At least for the moment, I'm not buying anything. I've decided I'm going to use stuff I've got. And then we'll see if I can get something for once a month. I'm going with this light beige color. And this is going to be on my M562 from Morphe. Light beige. Yeah, it's a pinky beige. I don't know how to call it. I don't like that the fact there's no names on it. And you see in the back of the chroma palette, you can see the back of the little eyeshadow metal boxes where they put in and the glue, so it doesn't look that nice, but you should have put a bigger sticker on it. But yeah, this color is also very vibrant and very pretty, even though it's a neutral shade. Yeah, and the black is also from this palette, so yeah, the shades that I've used are really, really nice. And of course, I swatched them all, and you've seen the swatches, and the swatches was amazing as well, so yeah. I should have gotten that part out because I'm staring at something else, but oh well, I didn't. So yeah, I'm staring at something else. I'm staring at my tablet because that's what I do when I do my voiceovers. I just watch a little video. And now I can just film both eyes and then cut out one eye and then, yeah, you see one eye. And this is the color Island Fever and this is my ME2 brush. And yes, I know
in the end, this side is not as big as the other side of the other way around. I did not do it that well. I have to be practice more at the blown out look, because I even think I should have done the other colors a little bit more to the outside. But oh well, I tried. I did my best. I did whatever I could, and I failed a little bit. Still looks amazing. I love the look I came up with, but yeah, I did. I wanted a even more blown out look, even though I love the look, but yeah. So yeah, still going strong. And look at the yellow. I mean, it's technically on dry on the outside, because that's already done my face base and everything. So that's on dry base, and then in the inner corner it's on a wet base. So it looks amazing. The color is vibrant yellow. So yeah, I'm wondering, Daniela, is it as good as the one from the BH Cosmetics palette? Because I don't have that palette. But I think this yellow is amazing. We're now going to cut my crease with my blank canvas and the 7072 brush. Because yeah, that's what I want to do. And yeah, let's be honest, the dress is quite standard, because I always do a cut crease. And I always show you guys. If you ever not want to show me, let me know. But I'm thinking if I get new people and everything, and they don't want to watch old videos. So I always have it in there. I could speed it up. I've done that in the past, but I've stopped speeding everything up. Because now you can see how long it actually takes me to put it on. And I think that's better. I like that better. So yeah, if I like that better in a video, it's figured it's less smarter to do that. So I hope you love that too. So yeah, and look at this go. I think I've got now rewhite and feed black. And I haven't tried feed black yet, but I did try a rewhite. It's not the same consistency as this one. So even if I went to a bit white base, I would probably prefer blank canvas. Because this is really light on me, so that's nice. And then we go in with this gorgeous glass flipper shade, and of course on a mini pencil brush, which I've used very often on this channel, to be honest. And look at it go, that shimmer is just. And then we're gonna go with Guilty Pleasure on my 237 gesso brush, because yeah, that's what we always use here. And look at it. Oh, look at that purple shimmer, light purple. I really like that. And that mermaid shimmer in the inner corner is also magnifique, I think, at least. I don't know if I have bad makeup. I don't think I've had bad makeup. Or I'm just good at making it work. I don't know. I feel like I'm enjoying it. And enjoying trying new formulas and new things. And I love that I've got new makeup to play with from Sheglam, and it's really nice. So yeah, I'm enjoying it. I'm having fun. It's nice, it's purpley. It's but haven't made up. No, I don't know, but I love my makeup. Then we're going in with this gorgeous bluish purplish duochrome reflective color, which has technical colors in it. It's blue, but it's purple. It has blue purple, but I only feel like it has an aubergine purple, and it's just so good. In here you see a bluish, blackish purple, probably because I have a lot of black around it. But yeah, I don't know if you can see when I move, but it's this purple, and in a pan it has just all the beautiful shades, and I love it, and it's amazing, and I enjoy it. And yeah, we'll just go back in with Guilty Pleasure to blend them a little bit more together and into each other. Just yeah, had to be done. I'm living for this. Oh, I'm really loving it. I like this. Let's go back in with some black. And put this on the other corner to blend everything together. Just a little bit, not too much. And we're going in with the gorgeous black again on my GH 52 on the under eye. We'll keep using this brush for my under eye, so I won't mention it again. But yeah. Black is still nice. I did put a black liner on my waterline, but didn't show you. Then we're going in with the Wind to the Shim, to Swim, something like that. And look at it, yeah, it's so vibrant. I love it. I didn't put the bright pink under my eyes, but I didn't feel like that would work that well. So I'm going in with the beige from the Chromazone, of course, and blend it out. I don't know why, but I didn't feel like the pink should be underneath my eye. I don't know. Just didn't feel like it. And then we're going to go back in with the gorgeous yellow. Oh, this is beautiful to blend it into the outer corner a little bit, but not too much. So not under the eye, just on the outer corner. Quite like this. Yellow is so pretty. I love it. And then we're going to go in this shimmery, beautiful, heavenly, yellowy, light beigey kind of shimmer. And put this on the inner corner and brow on. Because, yeah, didn't have anything yet. And we need to look at how good. I'm going to do my lips with the, how is this called? Glam 101 from She Glam. And that's all that's on my lipstick. So, but it's a caramel color. So it's deep caramel, which I like. And that's also on the lipstick, but that's it. More, it's not on the packaging. And I throw away the boxes as soon as I could. But look, this liner goes on really nicely, really precise. I'm happy I could film all of it. So I sometimes mess that up filming my lips. But yeah, it has a wide enough angle, so that's nice. The bottom, which you normally never see. So yeah, I like the filming I did. I like the... I didn't feel the last one was as good filmed, so yeah, I like the way I filmed this one. It's way better for me, a little wider angle. I have to keep that up and try if I can make it, because it's easier to just zoom in the end, to be honest. That's a really nice dark lip liner. It went on so nice and smoothly, like you can see. And now we're gonna go in with the other side of the lipstick. Yep, I'm showing you other side of the lipstick. And just go in there. Yeah, the close-up of my lips again. Haha. Hope you love it. This is the only place I've got a couple of wrinkles. Not that I mind having wrinkles, but I have them. And yeah, then this lipstick goes on top of it. I really like this idea. I have to change the angle so my lips would be on the camera, or on the video. Yeah, I really like how it mixed with the liner as well. Works really well. And I like the fact that it looked a little bit bigger because of the darkness. I didn't do my Cupid's Bow that well. But
So, that's my full review of my She Glam stuff. I'm just telling you now, I want more. I just want it all. I just want all the makeup from them. I just... Oh, look at everything. My face looks amazing. That lipstick feels so incredibly nice. I don't know if the colors is really me or mine, but I always wonder if I use a darker lip liner, which color of our base of lip liner you use. And I always end up picking the wrong one myself. So I do like the fact that this has both on it and you use them together. It is nice. It is nice. I feel like I have it crooked, but my lips are crooked, so yeah. And my eyes, I mean, I'm coming closer, because look at it. It just, the glitter in the mid-beginning, and then the other purples and everything, and that black. Look at that fucking black. How beautiful is that? Yeah, my eye shapes are a little different. I just figured it out when I sat down again to film the outro. Because I did my hair and my lashes and everything. I didn't use extreme lashes. I did use my natural Lizzie lashes because, yeah, I want to try those and see how they go. And, I think the eyes speak for themselves. So I think it's nice to have sometimes have a smaller lash so that you see just all the beautifulness of my eyes. Because this came out amazing. I think, personally, I love it. I like it. It came so good. So nice. Yeah. I'm living for this. I love it. It is so good. And the quality is amazing. And these two, I'll turn them around. These two are my favorites now. These are so good. They're amazing. I need more shades of these. These are really nice. I hope I can get them to the end. But it looks like when you just smush it around with a ball, it will get to this part, I think. Because it's just here, up here where the blockade is stopper, that's what the word is, and the rest is perfect. And they're really nice. They're not that heavy, but they still look really pretty. I like the look of them too. The highlighters are really nice. I have to check if they have of that thing also a liquid highlight. That would be awesome. I don't know if I've seen that, or any liquid highlight, but I would prefer it if the liquid highlight would be in this package too, because that would be awesome. So She Glam, if you're watching this, you're not, but if I need that one in the highlight, because I don't think I've seen it. And if I did see it, like I said, the lip feels amazing. It's nice. Brow pencil also does their job, works really finely. I like this. I know Missa used a different one, but this one is good too, because it's really small and fine, and it's blended in there so nicely. And the palettes. I'm happy I used both palettes, because I did black. Have you seen that black? Missa, do you have this one? And if you do, what do you think? Is this almost as... I think it's almost as good as Noir. No, it's not the same, but it is really good. And then I used this one as well. And then the highlight is shimmery. I use this as inner corner highlight, so that's why I called it highlight. But it's so nice. It looks so good. I hope I did Gina justice and did it a little bit of a... sunset eye. But I really like it. And that glitter in the beginning on top of blank canvas. That's also so nice. I really like that. I had so much fun trying makeup again. Thank you Gina for the tip of doing a... sunset eye. I like it. It looks nice. I really enjoyed this. I had so much fun trying new makeup. I love trying new makeup. I will definitely use these more. These gorgeous palettes and stuff. And yeah, it's so good. And please, if you enjoyed this, then subscribe to my channel. Hit the notification bell. Give me a comment. Give me a like. It would be so amazing. I would love to have you. And if you want, you can also become a Patreon. I have a little Telegram group. We do Skypes every now and then. I've sent Christmas cards out to everyone that sent in their address this year. So yeah, if you like those things, then let me know. And I love you all. This was so much fun again. Be yourself. Be happy. And I'll see you on the next one.